I'm slightly apprehensive about showing my body, but if other people wince and say, I wonder what the matter with him is, that's their problem, it's not mine. I never thought, actually, that I was going to be a male stripper.
When I think about showing people my breasts, so I've talked to a lot of friends about doing this, and it feels like I'm showing someone my leg, actually.
Here we go.
I've become very detached from my own breasts.
My mum didn't want to see it because she felt it would upset her.
Like with bracelets and hair, or maybe, you know, something like that.
And I've showed it to a few friends, but yes, I'm a little bit nervous about this.
My name's Bronwyn Fowles, I'm a photographer. I had one lady I interviewed, she just had a breast reconstruction. She said, they've taken my breasts, they've taken my ovaries, who's going to want to love me? And I thought, why can't I take this beautiful girl and throw her in front of a camera and make her feel beautiful?
Not having breasts is easy in lots of ways. You don't have to wear a bra, you can lie quite comfortably sleeping on your stomach. My son says to me I'm easier to cuddle because he can get his arms right around me. My name's Tina, I'm 37. I've had a bilateral mastectomy and I don't plan to have a reconstruction. I remember as soon as I woke up after the surgery and when I did open up my pyjamas and had a look, I remember thinking, that's okay, I can deal with this.
I had an immediate reconstruction. I needed to go all the way. I needed to have breasts, I needed to have nipples, I needed to have them tattooed, I needed the whole thing.
My name's Sarah, I'm 37 years old. I was diagnosed with breast cancer 8 years ago. I had a bilateral mastectomy 4 years ago with an immediate reconstruction using my lap muscle.
So this is where they cut me open to remove my lap muscle and they move it around and it now sits here. So you can actually see this here is my back, that's why the skin's a different colour.
So if you look close up, I mean not that many people do, but they don't look real, they don't feel real, they're hard, they're cold, and I'm completely numb in my chest area.
You know, like when you're walking out the back.
I played a lot of sport, so I'm not a sissy. When I was diagnosed with breast cancer, of course it came as a great shock to me. My name is Mark Foster. I've just had my 78th birthday. I had a total mastectomy of the left side. I do wince a bit when I look at it and I don't like to dwell on it, but it's there and so I just get on with it.
People look at me and go, that was something in my past, but for me, I live with this every day, like, and I will for the rest of my life. I have these scars, I have these boobs that aren't real, and so I think that unfortunately the body image thing will stay with you. It will, it's just part of who you are and it's kind of the new you.
It's not a bad look, is it? I mean, you know, it's not a bad look. I don't think out there is a great deal of support for men who have breast cancer. I actually haven't talk to any other man. I googled tamoxifen and to find out the side effects, and the only side effects I could find was that I was liable to get hot flushes and a dry vagina. So that was, it's all very pink out there.
When I look in the mirror, I just see myself because this is now me. I think the best part of my body is my mind, that's still there, and you know, I think when something like this happens to you, it shows you that you better have more to you than all that superficial stuff.
Well, they made me look quite good actually, didn't they?
I love the photos and they love the photos. You know, they're blown away with how they actually look and it makes them feel good, and that's what I wanted to do. I want to make them feel beautiful because they are beautiful.